that's bigger, better, and packed with more flavor than ever. I'm talking about the SeaWorld Seven Seas Food Festival happening right now at SeaWorld San Antonio. And here to tell us all about the yum-yum that you can have is Chef Scott. Look at this spread that we have in front of us. And we're talking more than 100 international flavors?
More than 100 international flavors, counting food, counting beverages, adult beverages, to keep you guys sane while you're here. There's so much going on in here, more than 50 food items right here. What I have in front of you is a representation of just three of our areas here. I've got Korea. Korea is our newest. I have Japan. And I have Hawaii here representing. So out of the Korea realm, I've got a bulgogi bowl. Mm-hmm. Rice, house-made bulgogi, where we're making the marinade, we marinate it, we griddle it off, fresh radishes, there's gonna be green onions, cucumbers, kimjeon, which is a kimchi pancake. We actually ferment the kimchi here. So we plus it up a little bit, we got it going on, and it's with a chochangang sauce, a dipping sauce, a little bit of soy, a little bit of spice behind it. For the fun theme park, we have kimchi fries. So it's all about the kimchi when we get into Korea. Beer cheese, kimchi, bulgogi, coriander, just lots of good stuff. Galbi, Korean short ribs. Moving over to Japan, we've got our red tuna tataki, ponzu, arugula, and then a beautiful yellowfin tuna with a little bit of red chili on there. Sticky ribs from Hawaii, mm-hmm. Poke bowls from Hawaii. We do salmon, we do tuna, huli huli chicken wings, which is a turn chicken in Hawaii with a nice little sweet slaw that we have. We've got gyoza, house-made dipping sauce, spam fries. And I know it sounds weird, but spam fries with a garlic chili dipping sauce. And then back over to Japan, we've got two types of yakisoba. One for the meat eaters, which is our chicken yakisoba. One for the vegetarians and vegans that are out there. We've got a jackfruit yakisoba. Plus sorbets, we've got coconut sorbet, pineapple sorbet. We'll mix them both together. You'll have a pina colada sorbet. The adult dessert, our soju sunrise, which is an adult beverage featured here in Korea. Soju, it's a distilled rice alcohol mixed with sake, orange juice, and we also have a little bit of grenadine in there to kind of give it the sunrise look inside there. That's just some of our items, Fiona.
And so this year, you've got the most new items added to the Seven Seas Food Festival than ever before. And there's also a whiskey flight, right?
There is the whiskey barrel, okay, where you can get whiskey tasting. Uh-huh. It's all top shelf, really good name whiskeys. Some are local, some are your fan favorites that have been around for centuries.
And so, some of the other countries.
We got Brazil represented. We got France, Mexico. We have Germany, which is also new. Italy, Greece. There's a lot of good stuff inside of here.
How can they sample it? How can they taste it all?
For our pass members, we're running this special. Basically, as a pass member, if you purchase our 15-punch lanyard, which is what I recommend, it's $75. But as a pass holder, we're going to give you three more punches. So in essence, you're getting 18 punches for $75. You go around, each drink is a sample, we'll give you a punch. Each food item will get you, it'll cost you one punch. So if you've got 15 of those, mix or match however you want.
Once again, the SeaWorld Seven Seas Food Festival goes through the end of May. For more information and information on tickets, all you have to do is head to SeaWorldSanAntonio.com. All right, right now on SALive.com, you can enter to win a family four-pack to SeaWorld. We have the contest rules and an article on our website. Just look for the story on the homepage at SALive.com.